Okay, so I wanted to review from last video. In the previous video, we went over the layers of the earth, the interior, and now we're working our way up toward the crust. Now, before we get to the crust, what is the layer right below where we get solid earth? You know, rocks, minerals, that kind of thing. Okay, it was the asthenosphere. That's the weak sphere. That is where we have tar-like fluid motion. Maybe it's even liquid near the seafloor spreading zone. But basically, that's what the crust ride upon and probably float or move during plate tectonics. So let's take a look at the two types. We have oceanic, or ocean I put behind me, and continental. The oceanic or ocean plates are thin. The continental plates are thick. We're looking at 5 to 10 kilometers on the thin side, upwards of 90 kilometers on the thick side for continents. Mountains are very, have thick bases or roots, and so the continents can be quite large and deep. That's what I meant to say. These are more dense. This is less dense. So if I take my wedding band here, here's gold, and it's really quite heavy. Okay, so gold's a good example of something that is very dense and heavy. The oceanic plates, which have, you know, heavy minerals and rocks like basalt and ultramafic rocks that we'll get into later, they're going to be pretty dense. And when we get into subduction and plate tectonics, they're going to go beneath the continents into these deep oceanic trenches. And then on the continental side, these are lighter rocks. We're going to refer to these as granitic. I didn't write that down. Ran out of room. And then these ones are going to be more basalt-like, okay, or ultramafic on the seafloor. This is much more uniform in its consistency of rocks. And this one is much more mixed as we get into the continent. And we will talk about elements and minerals, but the two most abundant elements in the crust of the earth are oxygen and silicon, oxygen being the largest, and that does mix with other elements. And we've got a lot of that here in the continents. So let's take a look at specifics on the types of rocks and minerals that we'd have in the ocean basins and then on the continents. So over here we have a basalt, okay, and this is going to have those dark colored minerals like pyroxene, ultramafic kind of stuff. Same thing with the gabbros. This would be a little deeper in the earth where it has time to cool, and we'll talk about igneous intrusive rocks. These are igneous rocks. Here's a metamorphic rock called serpentine. It is California state rock. Okay, and this has olivine, that's the mineral, and that is this greenish color that you see. These rocks and minerals form the ocean basins or the oceanic crust. We move on to the continental crust, you're going to have more of the granitics, right? So let's grab a piece of granite here. Here's a granite. And the types of minerals that we're going to have in here, the biggies are oxygen and silicon. We're going to talk about elements here in just a second. Mica and the feldspars that give it this color. So those are some of the minerals, and they're lighter. Again, we characterize it as granitic. Here's a rock that has a lot of quartz in it. Okay, quartz is basically oxygen and silicon mixed together. All right, and that gives it this light color as well as not as dense. And then here's another one that is an andesite. This is a volcanic rock. You find these in the Andes Mountains, but also lots of this in the Sierra Nevadas. And this is it has lots of silica or silicates, and therefore we call this, you know, the lighter continental crust. So let's take a look now at elements and minerals. Okay, let's take a look at elements now. And just a few disclaimers here. One is that this is really into the realm of chemistry as well as minerals. And two is this, you know, I'm not really an expert on this. However, because we keep talking about elements, it's important to visit that as well as minerals here in physical geography. All right, I'm going to point to a few elements. Hydrogen, helium, very abundant. Let's take a look at the Earth's core. We talked about that already. So here is nickel and iron in the center of the Earth. The Earth's core has these heavy elements. As we work our way up through the mantle, then we get in toward the crust. We get into oxygen, silicon. Those are the most abundant elements. Oxygen first, silicon second. Another element that's very abundant in the Earth's crust is aluminum, okay? And then over in here, we're going to talk about rocks. We're going to mention sodium, that's Na, potassium, there it is, K, calcium. Okay, so we do selectively, as geologists and earth scientists and as geographers, we do selectively choose, you know, the earth selectively chooses, I should say, these elements that are very common in some of the minerals as well as the rocks. So now let's take a look at minerals. Okay, next are minerals, and those are elements that are put together in a fairly pure form. There is a chemical formula for that. For example, quartz is going to be silicon and oxygen. That's a really easy one for me to remember. Okay, so that would be a mineral, quartz. All right, and I have a picture of some different minerals over in here. You know, sulfur's actually, these are even my more favorite. One of the characteristics of a mineral is there are a few of them, but the natives are actually just an element. So gold, silver, copper, sulfur, carbon, those are actually native, and that is that the mineral and the elements are one and the same. Okay, so here we have sulfur. And some of the characteristics of minerals are their color, and that would affect us here in physical geography. Second would be, let's say, the fracture zones, you know, the hardness in the landscapes. We're going to have some landforms that are going to be prominent. For example, right behind me where I live here in Auburn is the American River Canyon, and we have rapids where we see very hard rocks, and of course those rocks are made up of very hard minerals. All right, and there are many properties if you were to take an earth science or geology class. We don't need to get into that here, but certainly color, hardness, fracture zones, luster is another one of those properties for minerals. So in short and in summary, minerals are made up of elements, and number two, elements make up rocks. All right, and finally, let's talk about rocks. We are going to mention all the details again here in the next video, but I wanted to just show you granite, for example, has lots of quartz in it, lots of feldspars, it has mica in it. Okay, so it has different minerals that make it up. It's one of my favorite rocks, by the way. We have a lot of this in the gold country. Let me show you a few other igneous rocks. You know, we have lava rocks. This is a basalt. We also have another basalt, a very dark colored rock. We'll get into what's called mafic. And here's one of my favorites. Look at this guy. This is red. It has iron in it. I found this up near Chico, California in the creek. It's all rounded. Okay, so there were old ancient lava flows. Here in the Sierra Nevadas, we have granites. We also have gabbros. Okay, it's a dark colored rock that's formed in the interior of the earth. Moving over into sedimentary real quick, there are three subcategories. Should just know it right now before we head on. First are the clastics, and we have sandstones. Found this in Santa Cruz. Really pretty rock, isn't it? We also have the middle category are organics, limestones, coal, chalk, anything that maybe has oceanic microorganisms in the rock itself is called an organic. Limestone has that. And the third one is called a chemical, or chemical precipitates. In the next video, I shorten it to precipitates, but it's really a chemical precipitate, or chemical is more common. And this is a limestone. Limestones we have right here in the Sierra Nevada foothills, in the cool quarry. I'm going to take a flight and we take a look at it. I don't know if it's before this video or after this video, but basically take a look at the flight. You'll see the cool quarry. And anyway, limestone is one of my favorites. It's very abundant. It has moved a long ways. And then finally, our metamorphic rocks. Here's our state rock called serpentine. It has this greenish color from olivine, the mineral in it. Okay, so serpentine, it's a metamorphic rock. If you take a limestone and metamorphose it, like over in the cool quarry, you will see marble. Okay, so if it's metamorphosed, you'll see marble. If you take these mudstones and sandstones and you metamorphose them, here are some sand dunes. Okay, this is an ancient, not sand dunes, I meant ripples from an old pond. This is a sandstone that's been metamorphosed. We have a lot of mudstones around here that have been metamorphosed, and it looks like a dino claw. Here's a slate. We have slates in the foothills here. And we also have this gneiss that has a banding gneiss. Here's a schist. These are also metamorphic rocks that you'd find. This one you'd find around here. This one I found in Wyoming. I'm not sure if we find this. It's a little bit more uncommon, but it's called a gneiss. So that concludes it for the section on the crust, the section on elements, the section on minerals, and then kind of a preview of rocks.